Compassion fatigue is that profound physical and emotional exhaustion that caregivers have, and professional caregivers, the work that I do is mostly with professional caregivers. So it's that profound exhaustion that you have from repeated exposure to very emotional events and emotional situations with their patients. I think that people do think that compassion fatigue is part of the job, and in a way it is, because it's an occupational hazard of the job. So I think we can all expect at some point in our career to have some feelings or element of compassion fatigue, and that's why it's so important to be aware of it, so that we know in advance what our signs and symptoms are, if we're approaching compassion fatigue, and what we should do about it, and what we should do in advance of that, so that we look after ourselves to try to prevent it from happening. I think actually the most important thing is awareness, and awareness on many levels. So awareness in terms of education, so educating ourselves about what compassion fatigue is, and having a self-awareness. So that self-awareness is understanding our own signs and symptoms. So for example, for me, it's forgetting. So when I am overwhelmed, I forget things. I forget to attend a meeting, I forget a number of different things, and I also silence people. So someone could be telling me something, I just cannot listen to that kind of emotion anymore, and I change the subject. And when that happens to me, I know that's my warning sign. So self-awareness of your own warning signs is very, very important. And compassion fatigue comes home with you. It's not like burnout. So if you're burnt out at work, if you go on a holiday, often you can feel good and relax, enjoy yourself. You go home, you can relax, enjoy yourself. Compassion fatigue comes home with you. It's pervasive in all areas of your life, which is what makes it all the more significant, because it impacts on our relationships. It impacts on our relationships with our children, with our partners, with other people in our lives. So that's why it is so important to understand it and take stock of our lives and to really get educated on how to manage it. Sometimes they do lose their compassion in a way. They haven't really lost it, but they've masked it, they've hidden it. Because when you're in the throes of compassion fatigue, how you protect yourself is you put a barrier up so that you no longer feel this barrage of emotions that's coming at you. So you put a wall up, and then you become one of those professionals that appears distant or short-tempered or not caring. And often that's because that person is protecting themselves because they haven't perhaps got the strategies, or in that particular time they're feeling particularly vulnerable. And so they may not be as compassionate as they could. I think physicians maybe don't recognize it as well as they should, or acknowledge it as well as they should. There's a lot of literature now in the nursing literature that shows that they're identifying it, recognizing it, and trying to create strategies to help themselves. Social work, there's a lot of literature. In the physician literature, there's not so much. The literature talks about its existence. We don't really know what the prevalence is. We don't know what the best strategies are for physicians. So it is becoming more talked about. People are understanding it more now, but we've still got a long way to go.